The pathologist is sort of the hard drive of the hospital system. We are providing this key information that then everyone else can work off of to help the patient. A pathologist comes into play when the clinician has a question about the diagnosis. What is the patient presenting me with? So they need to take a tissue sample or a blood sample or some other kind of sample. And we do our magic behind the scenes and come up with the answer. In a cancer patient, first just the initial diagnosis of cancer will let everybody on the team know this is what we're dealing with. And now we have to think about treatment, which might be chemotherapy, radiation therapy, and or surgery. So it starts with the pathology diagnosis, and then everything else happens. A pathology report contains all the information that the clinician needs to decide what is the next step for the patient. In thinking about cancer, it's useful to consider the two types of specimens we're dealing with. One is the initial diagnostic biopsy. And in some patients, that may be all that is ever needed. And we give a diagnosis that establishes that there is a tumor of some sort there. On that small specimen, we can then usually give a little bit more information by doing some molecular testing or biomarker testing that will already point towards which therapies might work better than other therapies. The second scenario is that one has a diagnosis of cancer and now they've had a complete surgical resection to remove it entirely. In that case, all the message is about how far has it spread. So the pathology report from a patient who's had a surgical resection will contain something called a synoptic report. That includes what's called the surgical margins. Was it completely excised? Is it gone or is there something left behind? Is there lymph vessel or blood vessel or even perineural, the nerves? Is there tumor around nerves? So has it spread within this resection? How many lymph nodes might be involved by the tumor? That is always included if lymph nodes have been removed. And again, lymph nodes can be thought of as just a highway of structures that are draining normal waste fluids from every part of the body. We also measure the tumor so that we can arrive at both a grade and a stage, something called the American Joint Cancer Committee, or AJCC stage. And patients will see that on every cancer report from a resection. The questions you may have on your report, call your doctor, your surgeon, your oncologist, whoever is taking care of you. That's the place to start with your questions. What we say as pathologists is that you don't want a quick answer. You want the right answer. And that means we have to be accurate and, more importantly, complete. To be complete, these days, we need to apply the biomarkers and molecular markers and tumor profiling tests. That is the whole reason patients come to Yale Smilo Cancer Center for care, because we do it all. We have the highest level of expertise. We get all the information that you need, that your doctor needs, to decide with you what will be the next best step for your care, because it's the next best step in your care that will hopefully give you the best possible outcome for your future.